affected.
Okay, but all of these people who say that they are not based on the Chinese astrology and based on feng shui, who are not going to be so lucky, there are things that they can do to
yes, but there's also one parameter in feng shui, in, again based on elements, since it's a metal element here.
Uh-huh.
If your element in feng shui is fire, let's say you're a fire rooster, let's say born 1957, you're exempted because fire can burn metal, and you can mm-hmm. overcome all the challenges of the metal year.
Okay, so as this expert that you say you are in feng shui, what do you actually tell people on how to improve their luck? Is this what you actually tell them?
Yes.
Or how to improve their businesses?
Actually, improve the literal term will really improve their feng shui. Feng shui taken to be the management of their life energies in wherever they stay, at home, at work, and at play.
And why would one depend on your wisdom as far as what would help them in their businesses or in their personal lives?
Because of our primary concern in terms of survival will really be our well-being and the well-being of our loved ones. And it starts with ourselves by being productive.
And your role is to point to them which are the ones that will not help them and which are the ones that could help them?
Yes, to warn them against negative energies that can affect their productivity and improve their productivity further.
Sample. How can you, don't give me names, no? Okay. Just give me an example of how do you actually come in and help someone who is not going to be good doing good this year and tell them to do otherwise so they can do better in business.
Okay. For example, there is also what you call a change, like a biorhythm in feng shui. Every year, there are four bad directions and four good directions, which you should be aware of. It's like you're manning your house, that is your fort, and you have your sentries or security guards, your blue guards. You have to defend where the bad wind is coming from. So
this year it's
four bad directions. The worst would be the east.
East.
The east would be a very bad direction. Also the south, and southwest, and the center of the home. The center is considered a direction in feng shui. So you have to defend these directions by what you call feng shui maintenance.
So you don't buy property in the east, is that what you're saying?
Yes.
You don't direct your house towards the east.
Yes, and you don't also renovate or repair your house towards the east this year, or the south for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
So there are directions that like southwest, if you put a negative object there or you do something, it can trigger what you call even romantic affairs.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where you can experience sometimes a family is progressing, then suddenly the husband goes astray.
Mm. We asked our friends, Aldrich, in our social media accounts to send questions. On Twitter, Sunshi Fairy asked, how will wood rabbits fare this year and how do we counter the negative things?
Okay, wood rabbits will be badly affected because the metal element of the metal rabbit chops their energy. So they will be, they can be affected on three fronts. It can be loss of love or a loved one, or even loss of your own life, like we've seen used now in terms of tragedies, like the bus experience today, the collision.
And that was seen in the metal tiger.
It's still metal tiger, but now there's already a preview of the rabbit here, just like a film. There's a trailer already.
Mm-hmm.
So you see metal to metal clashing, two vehicles. That's a literal translation of feng shui.
Mm-hmm.
So the other front is could be loss of money or health in business.
But she can counter these things.
Yes.
Okay, and how does she do that?
The bridge to the metal rabbit is borrowing also from concepts like law of attraction to attract more luck. You can put a dragon figurine anywhere in your living room. And there is what you call a protective figurine in feng shui, like a pixie called the piao. And all you have to do is make this face the east, back to the west.
And why would they bring you better luck? if you use these things?
Symbols are forms of energy. Like the way you use your ABS logo or your school logo, be it Ateneo, LaSalle, or UAAP, or NCAA mm-hmm. League, the way it enervates or energizes you with resonance of energy, the animo in it, affects you. So, symbols like this trigger, by the power of thought, the electromagnetic reaction that mm-hmm. can make what you wish manifest.
On Facebook, Gian asks, is it a lucky year or not for the earth rats?
For earth rats, all rats now, except fire rat, are greatly affected. And this is very significant because the feng shui of a country is based on the feng shui of the president. And unfortunately,
and the president's feng shui is
a metal rat. So you will see a lot of conflicts. We can already see this during the last quarter, starting with the Chinese hostage crisis, and even in love life, and this recent Supreme Court ruling.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Maricar asked, what about the monkeys?
Monkeys are in now for a recovery because this metal tiger year, they were into their worst year, like what the rat is entering now. But now the monkeys are gradually recovering, and by February 3, they're full-blown on course for full recovery in terms mm-hmm. of whatever losses they had this year.
Okay, we also have questions from our viewers, and here are two questions from Edna and Myrna.
Sa tingin niyo po ba yung year of the ram is maswerte ngayong taong 2011?
Ang year of the ox, maswerte ngayon sa year of the rabbit? Maswerte ba sa negosyo ngayon?
For the year
of the ram, yes. Is it lucky for the year of the sheep? Sheep is ram, no?
Sheep and ox, well, they're...
Ram, what is ram?
Ram is year of the sheep also.
Sheep, yeah.
In feng shui. Then both of them are extremely lucky this year. So you can see, let's say, personalities akin to the sheep, mm-hmm. like the likes of Edu Manzano, Lito, Senator Lito Lapid. They're very lucky in their current state of situations right now. And for the ox, an exemplar would be a famous ox, former President Arap. So you'll see the progress of... Even in the United States, the president of the United States, Obama, is ox. That this augurs well for the U.S. economy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So you have had your own range of people who consult you.
Yes.
And you actually look at them individually and their environment.
Yes, even institutions like mm-hmm. the rehabilitation of NLEX. All it took was a turtle figurine to turn it around and enable a Sumitomo Bank Loan Consortium to release 13 billion pesos to proceed with the helping of our economy.
You're talking of the repair of the NLEX or the...
The rehabilitation.
The rehabilitation?
That was stagnant for over 9 years. Mm-hmm. MNTC, Manila North Tollways Corporation,
yes.
couldn't get the loan going because out of 11 consortium banks, there's always one, the Japanese bank, who would reject it. So only after feng shui did the Sumitomo vice president, when he saw the environment of the office already changed, and asked, did you have this feng shui? And he then consented, now you know what you're doing. We push through with your loan.
When you say, did you have your office space... What happened to the office space? They had some rearrangement.
It's just a matter
as far
of,
as furniture and windows and doors.
Not windows. It's just the workstation. A matter of shifting the energies for more productivity of the individual concerned in the subject workstation.
Okay, and you're telling me that a lot of these big business, the ones in the top 100 in the Philippines.
Yes, even the
rely on feng shui or not rely, consult.
Yes, a classic case would be the turnaround of Philippine Airlines in 1999, where the Cathay Regency Group recommended to Dr. Lushutan to, they said that if they needed 200 million equity infusion, $200 million, that if they meet a problem like this in Hong Kong, they would already summon the Feng Shui man. And fortunately, I was a speaker then for a Rotary District Convention, and they were there. So we did Feng Shui consultation thereafter.